How to make a model using SHAPR3D and the different ways we can use it for rendering with illustrations, with AI, or even 3D printing to create a physical model. In this workshop, we will talk about SHAPR3D, which is an app you can find on the Apple Store on your iPad. It is free to download, but there is also a pro version, which is particularly useful if you want to export your model in different formats. But know that there is an educational license, which makes it completely free. You can download the free PDF that comes along this workshop in the link below. Anyway, I'm going to make a model of a modern villa. So before starting a model, I like to have a clear concept about the design. I like to brainstorm and sketch all the things I have in mind and then start the model. So let's create a new project. First of all, you can play with the settings here on the upright corner. You can enable or disable the grid, the sketch guides, or the 3D guides. Also, make sure to select the right units before starting. So I start by tracing a line. The dimensions of my villa are not really accurate, by the way, so I'm just trying to create a model that looks overall correct here. Now that I have a square, I'm going to extrude it to have a box. This is the facet of the villa I want to draw first. By tapping with my finger on the right side of the box, I will have an elevation view that will make it easier for me to draw all the windows and terraces. Let's now model the other sides of the building. That's it. By the way, by tapping the upright square button here and going to Appearance, you can show the villa in an isometric or perspective view using the slider. I want to select the perspective view of this side of the villa to use it for my illustration. And for this, I usually use Procreate. You can also use it to generate images with AI, which can give you design ideas you can use as references. One thing I like to do after modeling on SHAPR3D is to 3D print the design, as you can save your file in different formats like STL and 3MF and send it directly to Cura on my laptop and 3D print the design like here to make some cute little physical model. Another thing, when you tap on modeling on the left up corner, you will see another tool called visualization. This is where you can actually add materials to your model, change the environment and the camera settings. If you tap again on visualization, you will see create drawing. You have to select the model, then choose sheet size, scale, and I will enable the button include four views. This creates a board with the 2D drawings or technical drawings of your 3D model. You can also add dimensions, then export your drawing. And of course, don't forget to name your project. That's all for me. If you've never used SHAPR3D, you might want to try it. It is really intuitive and easy to use, especially if you are used to software like SketchUp. So don't forget to download the PDF. And if you want to have free resources about illustration or architectural software or anything related to art and architecture, you can check out my website, my YouTube channel, and all my social medias in the links under this video. Feel free to connect with me if you have any questions or suggestions. See you!